Yeah, Smart Wargames here. Let's check out another classic Matrix Slytherin game. Guns of August, World War I, 1914-1918. That is a basically grand strategy game, World War I. And yeah, you can get it currently from the store. It's on a nice sale. Yeah, usually those classic games quite expensive, but on a sale I think for it is okay. And I will show you the content and what to expect from this game. Most important, installation, as we seldom have issues with installing some of those classic games, but usually always found solutions for that. No problem here, everything fine. On Windows 10, our newest operating system, Windows 11 will be basically the same, I guess. Yeah, just make sure install the main game and then install the update. There is a AI fix, just to make sure install first the AI fix and then the update. I guess the update is included, the AI fix is included in the update, but who knows. So I did it this way. Yes, there's a counter mod provided. I downloaded it and it looks nice. We will check it out at the end of the video. Yeah, manual, 40 pages. With a convenient index. Good, about the game. One thing you want to make sure is don't start this trench exe, or I don't know, perhaps G trench exe I was supposed to start. I would recommend you to start, maybe you're already in the game anyways, to start Autorun, which is in your main folder, and then press play game. Then it works. I started either one of those two exes and ended up with an invalid serial error message. And I use the autorun, it is working without problem. Next is, this game indicates that it is providing a resolution support for 1920x1080. I tried it out. You will end up with a window. Doesn't look too bad. It is basically a window covering like this. But you will see a lot of your desktop, not really that immersive. What I figured out, if your screen is supporting the, I mean, you will figure it out, find a resolution that fits you. I mean, you can also mix and match with your Windows resolution settings. But I found us the next sweet spot with 1680x1050. And while setting my Windows resolution also to 1680x1050. So I will have a full screen. The taskbar is visible, but I guess that is on purpose. The game comes with four scenarios, which basically present the state of war. You will play the entire Central Powers or Triple Entity. Yeah, and you have four years of warfare. Difficulty can be adjusted. There is some historical options like Italy joining Central Powers, Romania, Greece. So you can modify it a bit. If you, for example, play the triple and want to make it harder and let some of those nations join the Central Powers to have more challenge. Yeah, you can sound. I guess this is graphics. We might check out what this is. And yeah, PBM and hot seat. Yeah, so if you look for a nice World War One Christmas game, here you might have one for a couple of dollars. But we will now check out single player. Perhaps you need also to launch this as admin. And I remember I had a Matrix game where I had to set something either with admin or without admin, otherwise I received a serial thing. But this here one works, yeah, so it is fine. This game unfortunately doesn't have edge scrolling, so and there's also no mouse button modifier. So either you need to use arrow keys, which can be inconvenient if you are a person that wants to keep your his or her hand on the mouse. I would recommend to use a minimap to navigate quickly through the AO. Yeah, the AO is the entire World War One thing. Africa is a bit obstructed, but a thing. So perhaps in this scenario it is, I wonder why this black thing is here, or this wind mirror, perhaps it will open, I don't know. Because it wonders me that they kept this, could be that when the war progresses this will open up. Yeah, I'll show you the map. There seems to be only one zoom level. And yeah, the war is about to start. Not the limited war in here in Serbia, but basically the World War One is about to start. Yeah, interface, not that much here. We have different phases. This game works in phases. There's a strategic phase, there's an activation phase. You will see once I do it. Here you have some basic filters and yeah. Your music you can deactivate here by pressing this button. I mean, it is fine. I might lower it a bit. Yeah, victory conditions and how it is currently looking for you. We are currently not even in any phase. I think this is basically a start phase. Now the game will start. The nations are mobilizing. Let's see. What we can do is in the mobilization phase you can deploy HQs. Yeah, those we won't deploy. Those as well not. I want to bring the RT to the front line. Good. And of course there's also other theaters like Serbia. I might now play limited because I want to show you the features of the game. It is a strategic game. It requires of course time for a real video. If I now do it by the book, it will take a long time. So let's skip the Serbians and the Russians, but they are here and you can do the same stuff. You are even supposed to do that as you're in command of everybody. And of course of the British as well. But the French will of course see immediate action with the Germans. And that's why we, yeah, let's use a minimap, that is way more convenient. Good. After deployment phase comes strategic phase. Here you will see the strategic elements of the game. There's is not that much. You select a nation, let's say France. You basically manage all nations but individually. And you're not conducting diplomacy individually or R&D, but for every nation. Yeah, individually, not basically not for the entire alliance. And here you can do some stuff here, quite basic. You have, we for example can now invest a bit here into RT in order to progress RT research. ASW is anti-submarine warfare, aircraft. Nothing to talk, yeah, that is simply some sliders, not really that crazy, but for a quick game you have some strategic management without taking too much time. Like in a board game, basically, quickly in 5 seconds managed. Yeah, we research we talked about. Then we have some basic diplomacy, where also some minor nations are included, which you can talk and probably also draw to your side. Yeah, I think I just declared war in Italy. Happens, yeah, by yeah, I think we declared war in Italy. Now you know how to declare war, so watch out for that button. There's no check mark, nothing. Wait, is that true? Yeah, I think Italy disappeared. Italy, for some reason, doesn't want to talk to us. I suppose those guys are angry. Yeah. Interesting is that you are also in charge of naval forces. However, naval gameplay is not represented on this 2D map. But it is basically imagined, but you give ships orders like in some rule the waves. On the other hand, perhaps those ships will appear on the screen. Let's check it out. The British will of course have more ships. Let's do the naval part with the British because they have a big fleet. Yeah, units can be refitted, upgraded once technology improves, or also when they require manpower because of losses. Yeah, here HQ refits. Gas attacks is a resource, barrages, which can be handled then on the operational or the map in order to achieve whatever breakthrough or defense you seek. Air power, you can invest air strength. We have currently France has 2 air strength. We can attribute them currently to the Western Front. And then you can build forces. Yeah, for example, not only infantry, that is already scheduled for some reason. I guess that is introduction. And let's say you want some RT, and you can add it. And you want some submarine, French submarine, add it. So you see the strategic elements are there, but very fast-paced. I guess in order not to hold you up too long. Similar to board games, where strategic elements often are somewhat fast-paced. And yeah, you need to do this for every nation. For French, we are now done. Then you switch to, let's switch to the British and check, for example, naval forces. Here they, of course, have quite more around here. Battle cruisers, armored cruisers. I think it seems like the main fleet is currently not available here. Could be because they are always on response in order to face the Hochseeflotte. Perhaps that's only the ships they give you for other operational needs, while the big fleet of the British is basically assumed to be sitting and waiting for the German fleet to deploy. Yeah, but still, you can pick a battle cruiser here, Invincible, and conduct a surface radar patrol in the North Sea. And we will pick. Yeah, need to do it with shift, it seems. Or control. Windows controls here. Let's see, we use this here. I hope it worked out, but I think it did. So it will appear now on the map. Sooner or later. Exactly, and then you do that for every nation, Serbia, Britain, perhaps some nations will then join once you gain control over them. Like Italy, or Turkey for the central. We won't do that now because it would take too much time for the video. Let's keep it short. French is done, next phase. Exactly. War is declared. Western Front is opened. You get some news. What happened? Seems like it is rather historical news than in-game news. It's simply stuff happening. Pope Pius X died. I guess it has not really some impact on the game. And you see, that is basically the sea game is what you control. We have currently here, it works. We have currently 2 battlecruisers deployed and 2 armored cruisers to the North Sea, so we control it. Everything else is controlled by the Central Powers because we didn't put our resource in there. So that is basically, I guess, impacting on transports, supply and everything. You're not really moving around those ships on the map, but you playing this game of resource allocation, which is nice. And it is quite unique that naval warfare or trading warfare, shipping warfare is handled like this. But you can focus on a land war by basically assigning ships to the seas, similar to Rule the Waves, perhaps is somewhat similar, where you also assign ships to some theaters and then see what happens. Good, now we have activation phase. What happened to my music? Yeah, but I'm ready here, prepared. We are not sitting in full silence. Yeah, activation phase, you need to activate HQs. We will activate the entire front line, so we are able to maneuver. I will simply conduct battle. Yeah? I will run now into the Germans in order to show you combat. Of course, you shouldn't do that. Yeah? In the beginning, the Central Powers were quite pushing. We might face terrible losses by doing that. We can also press H. Oh, perhaps not. Oh, okay. We need to activate the menu, and then the hotkey works. Yeah, that is not really helpful. Good. Yeah, those stacks are now activated. You can also activate this HQ. Good. Yeah, then you can activate stacks. Next will be the orders phase. And now we can tell the entire stack or individual units. And we will simply move into the Germans. But you shouldn't do that. That is simply in order to show you how combat looks like. Yeah, some units can't move because there's a stack limit for every hex, it seems. Makes sense. Can simply deploy our entire army into a limited space. Yeah, and let's close a gap here in the Benelux states. And attack immediately. No, not possible. I'll bring the arty forward. Only not deployed, so we can move it around. And yeah, this HQ here is moving with the stack forward. This alone, I guess that is a higher HQ. But we will lose those battles. Yeah, that is basically suicidal. In the beginning, you should take it easy a bit. Try to delay the Germans. They are attacking and let them suffer losses while bringing in British forces onto the French mainland. Ah, here, you see even those units. Look at this here. The battlecruiser, armored cruiser squadron is now stationed here. And the Germans have the Blücher around. And there's also a Blücher was armored cruiser. Yeah. And I'm probably also conducting commerce radar. So we managed to get into the North Atlantic. And the Austrians are hitting the Mediterranean. Yeah, the counter answer is pretty nice. Sure, the game could be a bit more accessible when it comes to the controls, especially map controls and orders, but it is fine, yeah, you get used to it. One thing that is not looking so great is the combat phase. You're talking about those guys, right? I'll leave them there. Yeah, that is combat resolving. Sure, I have no sound, perhaps I deactivate it by pressing this button here. Now you hear gun sounds. Yeah, that is basically combat resolving. That is arty firing at location, losses inflicted, etc. Numbers rolling. And here you have some supply, and that's it. That is I guess I press this button, now we have sounds again. And yeah, as you see, the game is somewhat, it seems at least, also Vigo. You see, the Germans are moving and we are moving. It is similar, it is coming from the same developer, like this Napoleonic game here, Campaigns on the Danube. Which I like, yeah, so all orders are executed at the same time, it seems. Yeah, and here you have, for example, now a battle. A battle looks like this here. Exactly, yeah, attack failed, that was a German attack. And yeah, I think it's a bit hard to read. Exactly, Central Powers attacked. And yeah, I think that is the defender. Yeah, defender attacker, okay, now you get it. And they lost 7. Strength or whatever, readiness. We lost 8, but considering that they had superior firepower, it is pretty good trade here, and we managed to make the attack fail, or the Belgish managed it, the Belgians. Yeah, because they are probably also at the trench bonus, and the Germans basically tasting the bloodiness of trench warfare. But here Germany broke through. I think the Belgians were stationed here. Or we tried to get into here but didn't manage it. Yeah, it is overwhelming firepower. I mean, it's okay. I like data when combat is rolling, and I mean it is giving you some numbers and whatever, it is feeling at least to some extent satisfactory, so it is fine. Yeah, that is happening somewhere else. There's no quick click. You need to check simply the 1717 Austrians. No, that is us attacking here. Yeah, that is here, this yellow indication. Okay, and we won. Yeah, that was the attack I ordered. Well, it didn't work even out. I think that was, we wanted to get into this gap. The Germans got first here. We basically counter-attacked and are now forcing the Germans back. You see, trench warfare, it is going forward, backward already. Here the attack failed, as I predicted. Simply running into the Germans in the beginning is not good. You first need to wait and get your forces, yeah, especially the British, over and stabilize the front line. While bleeding the Germans out, counter-attacking right into Germany might not work out in the beginning. But here on the other hand, we managed it, which doesn't mean that we won. They're not retreating, but I mean this limited battle was a success. If you want to call it so, the Germans lost 3, we lost 2. In the beginning, I guess the Germans might have a strong force here on the Western Front, so if you can call this a win, a tactical victory, no doubt, but if it is an operational one, perhaps in the beginning it's better to sit in the trenches and let them come. Yeah, and that's how combat resolves in the face. And yeah. And you see the entire, so of course Russia is doing, but we are currently doing nothing with Russia. Of course we should do something and press Germany's Eastern Front. And the Austrians, of course, also here looking for trouble. Serbia is, of course, also a thing, still a thing, which basically started the entire thing. And yeah, that is how this game works. I think it's quite a unique, fresh, and fast-paced but not dumped down gameplay, which you can play in hot seat, multiplayer, local, whatever, quickly figure out the game. it is not something super complex, but perhaps that is also good. Yeah, you don't want something super complex. And what can I show you? Perhaps you want to see the end or the late war state, which might look quite different. Because the basic game, or the, yeah, you know how the game operates and what you can expect. I think I need to close the entire thing. And before we do that, I install the mod, which I have prepared here. Yeah, that is this Counters mod, which is basically even provided by Martex. So, Iron X, I think I heard that name in with John Tiller games, or now WDS games. Yeah, go into the graphics folders, and there is a Counters folder. Yeah, let's back up this thing. And then install the new counters and see how they look like. 139 counters are replaced. And let's go back into the game. I think I'll start this one here. Let's see if what happens if I start DG Trench. Okay, nothing happens. Yeah, as I mentioned. I know there's another game that requires the same, that you need to start the auto run and press play, otherwise you might suffer, face a error message. So I recommend, if you have any issues, start auto run and press here play, and then it should work. Good, this time we will start late, and perhaps central powers this time. Yeah, what is alternate? Now I installed the mod. Yeah, don't mix it up. Okay, yeah, I see the new counters. Yeah, that is quite a change. They now have a face, basically. Yeah, looks pretty good. Yeah, you see now the Turkish also here joining the party. Eastern Front is hard pressed, and I guess almost before the revolution. And the Western Front, yeah, let's press forward, see how it looks. Yeah, I won't do that much, I want to see simply how the front line looks. I want to see the enemy forces. Okay, that is basically the unknown counter. If you don't know what you're facing. Okay. But yeah, nice. Counter art. Yeah, it's basically the... Okay, wait. I see now the Ottomans here. Yeah, that's basically the ships that are available to you. You have some dreadnoughts. On the other hand, you have them, basically. But not all. I guess that's what Higher Command granted you to use for whatever sea domination. While the others are basically providing this, what being in fleet, sitting around and drawing enemy resources. And waiting for... a good opportunity. Kaiser, Dreadnought, okay. Modern battleships, basically. BB. You can also use them. And here, you can even decide on restricted submarine warfare. That is basically what triggered the US to join the war. But, yeah, I think... with this sinking of this... ship there. Yeah, but this here is still, okay, not a thing. that is a mirror here. This looks like if somebody put it on, I don't know. I would expect at least some information here, like, thanks for playing, or But I guess you can mod it. I don't know. You can add something here. Perhaps what you need to buy for your next supermarket. Because it looks so plain. No information. I would expect something like Guns of August. And perhaps a legend or whatever. I mean, there's not much information you need here, but it looks somehow interesting. Iron XSS is an excellent counter mod for Strategic Command World War II and World War I games. Ah, okay. They're now integrated in the official Matrix installers for these games. Ah, okay. That is good to know. Yeah, I think I heard this name with JTS mods for squad battles, but I'm not sure anymore. But yeah, nice. Good to have. You see modders. Pretty good to have modders around. Improving those games. And keeping them alive. Good, yeah, that is the game. I mean, yeah, Russia is already quite challenged. And probably in the rear, the revolution is already ravaging. And there might be soon the option for a ceasefire. While Italy joined the triple and is now engaged in this bloody mountain warfare that was also quite bloody. There's some, I mean, everything is focusing on this Western Front, which was also quite bloody, but this was also quite crazy. There was guys fighting in the mountains, making basically nothing, not an inch forward, not an inch backwards, but yeah. Okay, and let's check quickly out what is this alternate thing. I guess it is alternate graphics or something. And yeah, we can first check out hot seat mode. And Italy joins, everybody joins Central Powers. Everybody is friend of the Central Powers. Yeah, you can define a password. Oh, you need to do it, okay. Okay, no, don't tell it anybody. Password is nobody could ever get my password. Ah, damn it, you see it. Jimmy. Ah, okay. The graphics changed entirely. Yeah, not bad. That is quite a change here. Perhaps some might like this more. That has more war map up here. Doesn't look even that bad. It looks quite like a new game. Especially with those new counters. But look at this. The counters also changed to operational. I don't know if they wait. Let me check the folder. Is that mod? I can't tell now. Counters. Yeah, I'm not sure, but ah, no, the counters is here in the alternate folder. The alternate counters are in the alternate folder. Okay. Yeah, but those counters also look, that is quite something for serious wargamers here. That is some of the very great looking counters. Even for nowadays. And yeah, the map is also not bad. Simply, stylized. Like a war table. So definitely a nice option here. Good that we checked out this alternate. Yeah, and let's quickly see how here hot seat works. We are now Central Powers. Okay, now you define your password. Let's Jenny. Let's see how this works. Is there a black screen or something? There is. You see, units are not visible. And luckily, you do multiple phases at the same time, so people don't need to switch seats every 5 seconds. And now I guess it is another player is now coming. And you see the entire map goes blank. Then you can say, Jimmy, come over. It's your turn, Jimmy. Yeah, so hot seat mechanics are pretty professional. I mean, there are games that provide you hot seat, but they don't invest too much into intelligence or security. And then you need to figure it out somehow a bit difficult, because otherwise somebody might get a glimpse on the map or on what even if it is not that impossible in a game like this, but still, it is quite professional. Here you see nothing, you need to enter the password. And then you see the stuff. Yeah, that is also well done. And okay. Yeah, World War One fans or Grand Strategy fans might check this out. Especially on sale now. I think the price is fair. And yeah. Good, I come back in 5 minutes and then we check out last game for today. And then we basically have almost the entire Matrix catalog checked out. I don't know, Matrix playlist is running hot, 200 videos. And basically everything here. Guinness Book of Record, Matrix, all games. Yeah. Beijing is also approving here via high frequency transmission. Okay,